ICASA's Group HQ in Puzhou. My name is Jamie and I am the Head of Corporate Communications Department. And this video message is going to be the first of many that's going to be coming out. And I'm doing this on behalf of the top management team to give a message that's very important over today to especially the construction site team. Okay, so on behalf of Mr. Tan Chee Kian himself, our Group Chief Executive, we have a very important message to convey to you about safety on site at all construction sites and that the right way of construction management. So I'm honored to be able to have this opportunity to share this with you. And the first thing I'd like to do is I want to congratulate everyone who is working on site for having won and achieved the award, the Tapak Bina Sejahtera or Tabas Award recently in July from Majlis Perbandaran Sepang. So give yourself a big round of applause. This particular award actually is awarded because you have proven that the site is clean, it's helpful, and it's also safe for everybody who is working there. So for whatever you guys have done over there, good job. Congratulations. Now, to make sure that we are able to live up to this award, of course, spot checks are regularly done by the management team themselves. And lately, we've come across a few things that we do need to rectify immediately to make sure that the site remains clean, helpful, and safe for all of you to be working there. Now, first of all, when we went over to the 20th floor, we saw that there was a lot of tapau, teh tarik and teh ice and kopi o that's hanging everywhere where there is a hook, it's going to be hanging. So for example, like this, right? Hanging off the window on the 20th floor. Now, why this is very dangerous is if it should fall down, that even one bit of ice falling from that height down all the way down to hit someone or somebody's car, it's going to create an impact. Someone is going to be hurt. Someone's property is going to be damaged. So this is something that we don't want to have happen anymore. We don't want any tapau drinks hanging from any windows or hanging from anything inside the construction site. Now, also importantly, why we don't want tapau drinks is because it creates a lot of stains on the floor. So for example, you look at this picture over here. This is what we saw at the site. So stains on the floor, it's bad for the site because it also damages the site property. Another thing that we want to eliminate completely from the construction site is the act of smoking on site. Smoking, meroko, okay, in the construction site. We want to have no more smoking on site. Now the reason is because it's for safety reason and it's also to protect the property. On the construction site, especially in ITEC Tower Block C, what we have there is a lot of highly flammable materials like paint, like the carpet, and of course very expensive materials like new tiles and wooden flooring. So all the stains on the floor or anything from the cigarette bites from the floor, the burnt marks, they are going to destroy the property, and more importantly, it's also going to create a fire hazard for you working on the site, so it's very unsafe. So the third thing is this. The lift corridor, when we come out of the lift into the corridor is not very wide. So when a lot of things are plugged all over the corridor, it is very dangerous for anybody who is up there if anything should happen and you cannot escape properly because it's all blocked up. So the lift corridor needs to be clear and the walkway and pathway needs to be there. So this is very important to be able to look at immediately. And last but not least, we need to keep the area clean at all times. Now, how do we do that? One of the key things to do is to think ahead before we actually do something. So, for example, we have people who are cleaning every hour or so, the cleaners who are on site, which is great. Good job on that. But the thing is, there is one part, for example, where sawdust is being cut on one side and all the sawdust is flying everywhere. And it just defeats the purpose of the cleaner cleaning at all. So why don't we think of more effective ways of actually making sure that the sawdust is actually contained, like buying a machine that's actually have covered area, a covered container for the machine to contain the sawdust from flying out. And that way the site will remain clean automatically. And the cleaners don't have to do that much more work to make sure that it's clean all the time and then have that work become irrelevant. Okay, so these are four main key things and I'm going to repeat them here quickly. So no more tapau drinks and no more tapau drinks hanging on any window or any nail, just no more tapau drinks, full stop. Secondly, no more smoking on site, okay, because it's very dangerous and it also creates a lot of stain on the floor. Someone can get hurt if something gets inflamed and explodes. Now third thing is to keep the lift corridors clear, no more block corridors, also very dangerous because there's no clear walkway. And the fourth thing is to make sure that we get something to make sure that all the sawdust and all the construction materials are contained and keep the area as clean as possible at all times. And that is how we can make sure that we actually earn this award called Tabas, right? So these four things are there. Now, how do we replace all these four things? So for example, to replace the no more tapa drinks, you can use a water bottle. Use a small water bottle or a big water bottle and get the mamak guy to fill it up full for you. That way, we don't have to hang that, and you put it down, it's always closed up, so stains are also eliminated. And secondly, for cigarette smoking, this is how we're going to prevent it from happening on the construction site. You will not be allowed to smoke on the construction site at all. So the moment you enter ITEC Tower, before you can go up to the different floors, if you're working inside the building construction site, you will be checked at the ground floor by the guard, and this is a proposal that we need to arrange with the management team and the building management team to make sure that all your cigarette packets and also, of course, this point, dapao drinks will be removed and your cigarette packets will be put inside a bag. So let's say you're working on the 18, 19, 20 floor, there will be a tong or a bag or a pail for you to put all your things inside there, and when you leave later on, you can collect them back. Okay, that's what we're going to be doing from now onwards for you to make sure that we are all safe and there will not be smoking of any kind of cigarettes up on those floors in the construction site. Then thirdly, for keeping lift corridors clear, just make sure that everything is clear at all times. So no more blocked corridors like this, get clear corridors like this, okay? And last but not least, to make sure it's a clean area at all times, let's look at options of how we can make sure that sawdust or materials that are being cut are not flying all over the place all the time. So that one we'll leave it to the management at the construction site to decide and to propose to Mr. Tan what items or machinery they need to get to make sure that this is handled. Okay, so these are four main things, and it's very important that your cooperation is there. Not just because we want it so on the management side, but because it's for your personal safety if you're working on the site. Okay, it's definitely for your personal safety. We do not want any accidents at all to happen. Okay, now, so reminders is this. How do we make sure that we remember this all the time? And this is a very good message from Mr. Tan, because he just says one thing. Number one, keep your eyes open, right? Open your eyes and make sure you see, is this safe, is this not safe, should I do this, should I not do that? So when you are able to see and not just pretend it's not there, you'll know what to do naturally if you want to make sure you and your colleagues are safe at all time. Number two, imagine yourself, if something happens, okay, then if someone gets hurt, then what happens, right? And last but not least, just care. If you care, then you won't be blind. If you care, your eyes will be open. If you care, you will know how to imagine. So these are three messages, very important ones that I want to pass, convey on behalf of Mr. Tan Chee Kian, our Group Chief Executive, to you, all our construction site workers that we value very, very much. So starting from next week onwards and continuously, of course, there are going to be spot checks, and we do look forward to you making sure your site is at top-notch quality at all times. Thank you very much for listening so far. Please let us know your comments and your feedback. If you have anything you want to share about this and how to improve the site quality, we want to hear from you. Thank you.